It almost seems like I'm serving you the appetizer after the food is over. So whatever, this is the way how it is this time. So anyways, तो ये for this semester, मतलब the third semester, last year, whatever you have done, उसका ये थोड़ा सा, I mean you've understood the elements of structure, you've understood the stresses and things like that act on the structure, जैसे कि shear force क्या है, bending moment क्या है, you've plotted the bending moment diagram, the shear force diagram, you've calculated all those kinds of things. Now, what this semester is all about is understanding the stresses that are not in external terms but are in internal terms. So this basically would deal with internal stresses within the elements. Okay. So what is this? Aparna is requesting.
Sorry, it was by mistake. Sorry.
Okay, do I need to do anything?
No,
No.
you don't.
Okay. Yeah, all right. So that is what this is. So briefly, what we would cover in this semester is theory of bending, simple bending, deflections. Deflection basically is when the beams deflect. So how do you calculate the total deflection of the beams? What are the direct and bending stresses that happen during any kind of deflection? And points number 4 and 5, 4 though has been like very nicely covered by Neeraj and in a very extensive way. So I think that is pretty much done. Material testing, cement, sand, brick and concrete. Some of it might have been covered in the construction class, I think. If not, then we'll cover it here. ठीक है, तो दिस इज द वेरी ब्रीफ सिलेबस. अभी इसमें कैसा है, नाउ इन दिस मोड ऑफ टीचिंग आई डोंट नो हाउ विथ व्हाट ग्रेट डिटेल्स वी विल टेक इट, बट विल सी एज व्हेन वी कम टू इट. ओके, तो व्हाट वी विल टेक इट, सिंस नीरज ने ऑलरेडी आरसीसी शुरू कर दिया है, जिस थॉट की पूरा कॉन्क्रीट अभी बात करके खत्म कर देते, सो दैट टॉपिक इज डन इन done with and we can put it aside. So what usually I would have done is that we would have gone back in history and figured out how concrete came into existence. So the kind of concrete that we see today is not the kind of concrete was there at least 100 years ago, or even going back, even 6,000 to 3,000 BC. So, इसका फॉन्ट छोटा है क्या? आपको दिखाई दे रहा है?
इट्स परफेक्ट.
परफेक्ट? ओके. सो आई जस्ट थॉट कि वील टेक अ पॉज फ्रॉम द काइंड ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट दैट वी आर रियली अवेयर ऑफ एंड गो बैक टू सम काइंड ऑफ लाइक अ हिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट सो दैट we understand the evolution of building materials as such. ठीक है, तो there aren't too many good scientific evidence to show that कभी initially concrete existence में आया था. There are some reports and there are some discovery channel पे भी है and there are some scientific papers that talk about some kind of cement and concrete in the early 6,500 BC. But ये timeline में मैंने वो include नहीं किया है because those kinds of things are cited, but मतलब उसका ज़्यादा मुझे proof नहीं मिला. So concrete basically क्या होता है? There are three main ingredients in concrete. Yeah, one of the ingredient is the binder material. Binder is the material जिसका कैरेक्टरिस्टिक है टू स्टिक थिंग्स टुगेदर. या तो आप सोचो कि आपके पास तीन बॉक्सेस है, एक में आपने बाइंडर डाला है, दूसरे में यू हैव पुट द थिंग दैट यू ऑलरेडी नो इज वेरी गुड इन कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ. सो द स्टफ दैट इज वेरी गुड इन कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ इज स्टोन, ऑल काइंड ऑफ स्टोन एंड ऑल्सो सॉइल. mud and soil, right? Or dusre box mein aap you will put something which is going to make it in a pasty form, right? So if you take binder and you put the compressive material wala stone, it is not going to make concrete. So you have an essential thing, which is the water or the liquid part that goes in the to make this pasty form, and you can lay them. So the idea is to make, actually the idea is to make stone, yeah, stone of various kinds. So what the early inventors thought is that, okay, let's try to invent a kind of a stone that is far more rigid than the natural one, that can be easily cut in shape and can be transported easily. So that was the motive of doing something like that. Ye stone se aage badhke, you have people started thinking, acha isko, because you're using compressive material in it, isko abhi ye tension mein toot jayega. So how do you strengthen it when it actually bends and it breaks? And so how do you strengthen it? So people started using straw. Yeah, so the early instances of people using straw goes as back as 3000 BC, jab Egyptians used mud and straw and they made dried bricks. Yeah, so actually it is something that the Indo-Aryans have also used. So this goes back, you know, so many years ago, where they have actually used it. We still use it in compressed earth blocks. We use some kind of like a, you know, agricultural waste and mud, and we compress them and use. So it is still quite applicable. So maine kya diya yahan pe, Egyptians used mud and straw and make dried bricks. Yeah, so this is an attempt to make small bricks and make bricks that were easily sort of like dressed, you can dress it up and all those kind of things. The second instances are where Chinese started using these materials for the Great Wall construction, and they have also used them in making their boats. You know, they bound together boats, bamboo sticks, and they have sort of lined it with mud and mortar, and they've used them. So that's that. And then that's the picture of the great pyramids, jahan pe they have used almost as much as 5 lakh tons, 5 lakh tons of these kinds of binding material and mortar. Yeah, so those have been still used. And there are early evidences of Nabatean and Beduan traders using hydraulic lime for building underwater cisterns to store water. Now from there, they progress to using different kind of material, which is now lime. Yeah, pehle mud use kiya, uske baad mein they figured ki acha kuch aur use karenge, to maybe the binding strength will be better, and usse waterproof quality for all these kinds of things can become much better. So they started experimenting, and they have used all those kinds of things. Then there are instances where they started using bitumen to bind stones and bricks together. Yeah, the Babylonians have used it in all kinds of construction. Romans were the pioneers that was the innovation hub of building materials, in fact. So when the Romans basically went into sort of like decline, uske baad mein concrete construction and concrete ka innovation kafi drop ho gaya, because they were not using. And then sort of there was a revival of trying to use concrete again. Yeah, so there are instances, I've put pictures of those kinds of things. If you want all the papers that I have read and these kinds of things, please let me know. I'll put. It's quite interesting how they have innovated all these things, and how they have invented. They have even used animal fat and blood and milk and all those kinds of things to actually make the binding agent far more powerful. So it's quite I was thinking while I was doing the research, ऐसा कुछ तो एक lab हो गया where all these people are putting all these things and seeing and testing and God knows what kind of testing machines they had. But yeah, so next is we sort of like, you know, 470 AD say we'll come back to the early 18th century. So early 18th century mein, इंग्लैंड में देर वॉज दिस गाय कॉल्ड जोसेफ एस्पिरिन. ही वॉज साधारण एक यू नो मेसन था. ड्यूरिंग दोज टाइम्स ऑल द रिच पीपल के घर बनाने के लिए दे यूज टू हैव दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टोन कॉल्ड द इट वॉज लाइक अ वाइट सॉर्ट ऑफ लाइक स्टोन एंड इट यूज टू कम फ्रॉम पोर्टलैंड. पोर्टलैंड इज द नेम ऑफ अ प्लेस. या तो बेसिकली ही जस्ट इन्वेंटेड ही गॉट सम यू नो चॉक एंड क्ले. चॉक इज बेसिकली कैल्शियम लाइम हाइड्रोलिक लाइम एंड ऑल दोज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. ही बर्नड देम एंड ही ट्राइड टू सी इफ ही कैन मेक दिस आर्टिफिशियल स्टोन. या एंड देन एंड दैट्स हाउ बिकॉज ही वॉन्टेड टू एडवर्टाइज दिस न्यू मटीरियल ही यूज द वर्ड पोर्टलैंड. Yeah, so he started using Portland cement so that people would sort of like think that, okay, these are original stones that are coming from the place called Portland. And so he basically sort of like, that was his marketing strategy. So that's why the normal cement that we use today is called the Portland cement, because this Joseph Aspirin thought of his marketing strategy that way. Okay. आगे बढ़ते हैं. सो दैट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग बिकॉज सीमेंट बिकेम द एनहेंसमेंट ऑफ सीमेंट बिकेम द की फैक्टर इन कॉन्क्रीट इटसेल्फ बिकमिंग अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग मटीरियल. अभी के कॉन्क्रीट में आप देखोगे तो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज द सीमेंट इटसेल्फ. सो द अमाउंट ऑफ इनोवेशन एंड रिसर्च एंड टेक्नोलॉजी दैट हैज गॉन इन टू मेकिंग अ बेटर सीमेंट is a lot. Now let's go back to this guy Joseph Monnier. नीचे है 1840s में. Now this guy ये तो साधारण you know he used to साधारण he was like a gardener. Yeah. So this guy is in France now. So from there now we are coming to France. This guy is in he's doing all this garden mein he had all these orange orchards and orange trees. They used to freeze during winter times and usko transport karke they used to put it in the greenhouses so that they don't die during the winter season. He used to every year transport them into the greenhouse and the normal jo gamle mein wo rakhte the that used to break and all his he used to lose all his trees. So what he thought of is that chalo isme kuch aisa gamla banate hain jisme it's you know the stresses of the transporting will not hamper the health of his orange trees. So what he thought is that usko main ek jali mein pehle dal dunga gamle ko and then I'll make it. So that's the that sort of like inventing the reinforced cement concrete. So that is where so he's unknowingly or knowingly he's the father of the you know RCC in some sense. If you see the pictures that you see here just on top like a bridge and a cistern or a water tank are these things that he has made in his garden. So he used to be the chief gardener in all these big French chateaus and stuff. And he used to make all these rocky structures which were not really the natural, but he used to mimic the natural big stones and like a display of big stones and mountains and stuff like that. So this is a bridge that he has used jahan pe usne RCC use kiya. Basically isme jo side ke railings dikh rahe hain they are not made out of wood. It just resembles like jaise wood ke usne lumber use kiya hoga, but those are actually concrete that he has used to make and he's pretended that these are actually pretended to make that these are actually wood logs. Okay, so let's move ahead. 1853, so there's this guy called Francois Coigny. Okay, he's the person who actually first used concrete in buildings, the reinforced concrete in buildings. Usse pehle they were just using big blocks, big building blocks, stones and bricks and stuff. Lekin uske pehle nobody actually thought that a reinforced concrete could be used in buildings. So he's the guy who thought that this is a material that we can use there. So this the left corner pe jo hai wo uska ghar hai apparently, which still stands today. Okay, so 1892, the same French guy, this is a contractor, Hennebeek. He is the one who actually in some sense, aaj ka jo jaisa bhi concrete construction chalta hai, jaise shuttering hai, the whole bamboo laga ke, shuttering laga ke, and this entire system of pouring concrete and how you can get columns and how you can get flat ceilings and stuff like that, he is the one who invented that. So he had a construction company, a contractor construction company, and he also, I think, filed a patent for it, and which is still there. So that so you can say that he is the world's first construction contractor in some sense. So let's move ahead, fast forward karke. Basically from Hennebeek to now, that's pretty much the modern construction concrete that we see. Not just concrete, but reinforced cement concrete. Udhar se jo bhi modification hua hai, the modification has happened to get better foam work and shuttering systems in place, automated shuttering systems, and all the innovation has happened in making a better cement. Pani ke jagah pe we have used some kind of like admixtures, but the main basic formula still remains the same, that there is a binding material. There is the compressive strength ke liye ek material hai, aur ek liquid ya fluid state ka ek material, which is basically making your concrete, and you pour it in reinforcements. So there is a lot of betterment in all the kinds of steel that we are using today. So, but basic formula remains still the same. So this slide basically is just to tell you that what is the kind of ye abhi RCC ke baad, what is the amazing kind of construction and designs that engineers and architects have used to make use of RCC. Theek hai, abhi tak kisi ko koi question hai kya? Or Neeraj, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. So should we keep continuing then in that case?
Yeah.
Is that a yes? How efficient were concrete compared to today? Oh yeah, the concrete was much more efficient. The Roman structures still stand today after even 2000 years. There is a nice interesting paper that I came across which talks about specifically Roman concrete and how when they had to make these, and what they did is that instead to support their shorelines, they constructed some kind of like a sea wall, and it is still used today. And they did not realize that concrete, if it is with the right kind of materials, the concrete actually gains strength. Because it ages and there is chemical reactions in it, and so basically it gains strength. They had to sort of like एक portion of the wall उन लोगों को तोड़ना था and the amount of effort that they have taken to just demolish that little part. So the paper actually talks about that. So yeah, the concrete compared to concrete of today, well, we have become more efficient. But needless to say that that particular age का concrete is very still stands. So yeah.
Ethics involved, because I saw some of the materials and like, other than the ethics, is there a reason to that we haven't tried to recreate such a this thing?
Sorry, Shravan, I couldn't hear you well. You were asking about the materials that they used as raw materials they used, ऐसा?
Yeah, something like, because it's like I can understand ethical reasons to not use the materials because it involves a lot of animal products, but other than that, is there a reason they haven't really used it again?
Oh, okay, the animal product wala.
Yeah, because
Well,
like other than that, I don't
I
like
wouldn't till that extent to think about ethics. I mean, I think they
not that
were
bad.
innovators. The Romans were
Yeah.
anyways very high in terms of the kind of innovations that they've done in construction and is it's spellbound. तो मुझे नहीं लगता कि उसकी वजह से था. आई थिंक दे वर प्रिटी मच यूजिंग डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ थिंग्स टू फिगर आउट इसमें और क्या कर सकते हैं. दे ऑब्वियसली थॉट कि ये लाइन पे अगर इनोवेशन करते रहेंगे तो कुछ अच्छा ही निकलने वाला है. सो दे केप्ट ऑन सॉर्ट ऑफ डूइंग दैट. दे इनफैक्ट देर आर इंस्टेंसेस वेर दे हैव यूज्ड ये जो लाइम है, लाइम को जला के, लाइम स्टोन को जला के उसमें से देन दे क्रश इट. That's how actually cement is made, right? I mean, I hope you guys know that already. So they have already experimented with those kinds of things. So their innovation in some sense have reached quite ahead of in compared to today's times. I think they have done far better.
No, because we haven't recreated it yet, right? Like the same kind of cementing or concrete, we haven't really tried to recreate it as far as I know, right?
Yeah, we haven't. So the innovation that is happening is in the same because concrete का the main basic advantage is that it is moldable, right? Stone को carry करना, stone को उधर से एक quarry से दूसरे quarry तक carry करना. Imagine the amount of manual labor that will go in it. इमेजिन दी अमाउंट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन व्हीकल कितना बड़ा चाहिए. वहाँ पे तो पहले तो शायद वो वुडन लॉग्स पे ही घिस घिस के लेके जाते होंगे. सो आई थिंक जहाँ पे आपका कंस्ट्रक्शन है वहीं पे कॉन्क्रीट बनाना वुड हैव बीन अ वेरी ग्रेट प्लस, राइट? अभी अपने को इतना बड़ा इजी लगता है कि अरे बैग्स लेके आए, ये हो गया वो हो गया. बट उस जमाने में आई थिंक दी एडवांटेज ऑफ मेकिंग योर बिल्डिंग मटीरियल्स राइट एट द साइट वुड हैव बीन क्वाइट ग्रेट. और ये सब प्रोजेक्ट के लिए दे यूज टू टेक लाइक 50-100 ईयर्स टू मेक. सो आई थिंक दैट इज वॉट वुड हैव पुश देम टू कीप द रिसर्च गोइंग ऑन इन दैट एरिया.
And
बट दैट्स
also
दैट.
the innovations and the development which happens is according to the times. Like now, as you know, we have constructed Burj Khalifa, but at that times it was not the requirement to go vertical, or maybe the requirements were different basically. So the innovations happens also according to the
Need of
time,
the society,
need of the structure.
What's the second is what the binder used in Great Wall of yeah, they use sticky paste rice also. That is correct. So people have used many different kinds of things, and so you can actually read. They have really wanted to. सो दिस बाइंडिंग, ये जो तीन का जो कॉम्बो है ना, वो कभी एक्चुअली चेंज नहीं हुआ है. सो एक खास एक बाइंडिंग मटीरियल टू डेवलप अ वेरी गुड बाइंडिंग मटीरियल, देर हैज बीन अ लॉट ऑफ रिसर्च दैट इज डन. सो इफ यू वॉन्टेड टू मेक अ रियल स्ट्रॉन्ग कॉन्क्रीट स्ट्रक्चर, is it technically, yeah, I think it would be technically possible. So the thing is that the cement today that we make is a combination of lime, silica, alumina, and all those kinds of things. So if you really understand the chemical reaction that takes place, you can actually make those kinds of things. The concrete itself can last longer. The RCC does not last that longer because the R in the RCC is the reinforcement, right? Reinforcement basically corrodes. So it is bound to take moisture, even if it is not exposed to water that way. It is bound to take moisture, and the iron inside the RCC corrodes. And that's why RCC can't stay longer, but obviously concrete can stay stay much longer. And I don't know if you've heard that jitna bhi, as long as you keep the concrete hydrated, it ages and it gains strength. So there isn't any degradation part usme nahi aata hai. So should we still move ahead then? Any more questions? Okay. So this particular slide is talking about. This slide basically is inspired from all these great works, and there is this notion that RCC hai, to you know, aisa box type building hi banana hai, aur waisa sab. So and usme innovation possible nahi hai. So this is actually to break that kind of general misconception and things of that kind. So Robert Myla, Robert Myla was a civil engineer. Yahan pe jo uska arch bridge dikh raha hai, ek do arch bridges. So in the 1930s, so it was during those times in the 1930s. When he was creating these kinds of beautiful bridges. Now you can see how elegant they are, how efficient they are. And look at the kinds of flyover bridges and any kind of bridges that we are building now in the current time in the 21st century. So you can imagine the big gap that we have compared to other places. The big, huge, clunky designs that we have. With RCC, you will see the Andheri ka flyover and you will think that ye to bapre to 200 saal purana hona chahiye tha, kyunki look at the kind of condition that they are in. So he is actually Robert Mylart is the one. So if this were a normal class and if life was as normal, then the assignment basically is to study all these people, and make your own structures, understanding their main principles. So Mylart actually is the one who thought about three hinged arches for bridges. He was a civil engineer, but he also owned a construction company. He was the construction contractor, architect, everything all together. And he used to not do big, huge calculations, apparently. He used to just intuitively design and construction ho jata tha. Shuttering nikalne ke baad, he used to just walk over the bridge and check everything all by himself. And that used to be his like a test. I don't know if this story is set to just amuse us, but he was not those typical engineers who do all these kinds of calculations, big calculations, and figure out the deflection exactly to the mm and all that. Anyhow, so and then he's also I don't know if you have heard about mushroom columns, but he's also the inventor of mushroom columns. You've seen flat slabs, right? Flat slabs.
They might have seen, but I don't think they are.
So you will see abhi if you go to a shopping mall ka garage or something, you won't see any beams, hai na? You will see the column ke upar aisa square sa ek thingy hai, it's called the capital, and it's basically flat. So flat, that's, it's called flat slabs. पहले क्या होता था, the total weight of the structure that comes from the slab goes to the beam, and the beams are connected to the column, and the column takes the load, and then from there it goes to the columns at the next level, and like that to the foundation. Now, यहाँ पे beams नहीं है, ठीक है? So you get this increased height. आपका सारा services आपके slab से लग के जाएगा. अगर beam है तो वो beam के bottom से calculate होता है, ठीक है? तो ये फ्लैट स्लैब्स में क्या हो गया, यू गेट इंक्रीज्ड फ्लोर टू सीलिंग का हाइट. एंड द मशरूम कॉलम्स का फंडा ये है कि इफ़ यू टेक अ पीस ऑफ पेपर एंड इफ़ यू हैव अ पेंसिल और समथिंग एंड इफ यू पुट, इट्स वेरी इजी टू पियर्स थ्रू द पेपर, राइट? बट इफ यू स्टिक समथिंग, इफ यू स्टिक लाइक फोल्डेड 2-3 paper over that nib of the pen, then if you try to pierce through it, it won't, right? The reason is because there's something called punching shear. So if you have a big pointy column and you have a flat flat piece of paper in compared to the column, the slab would can be considered as a flat element. So it will puncture through the flat, it will puncture through the slab. सो उसको स्टॉप करने के लिए ही ब्रॉडेंड द माउथ ऑफ द कॉलम बेसिकली, एंड यू हैव द स्ट्रेसेस दैट आर गेटिंग इवनली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अराउंड अलोंग अ बिगर एरिया, राइट? सो दैट इज द आइडिया ऑफ द कॉलम कैपिटल. सो सो दैट इज दैट अबाउट हिम. एंड And during the 1930s itself, the Hoover Dam in US was made, which is the I think the first use of reinforced concrete at a very large scale, at a very massive scale, not just large, I think massive scale. The amount of concrete that they put in there, usually you can say that you can make a road around the globe or something like that. Anyhow, आगे बढ़ते हैं. Okay, yeah, so you have the falling water. So falling water was one of the first instances where large cantilevers of RCC was used, experimenting with cantilevers that are as large as something like 3.5 to 4 meters was used. So that is, so architects started thinking that RCC is this very nice innovative material, and a material where you can, they can use their artistic expressions the way they want it, because now they are not governed by the material that comes in shapes and sizes, and you can cut them or not cut them, but you can mold them to whatever you want, right? So that gave them this increased sort of flexibility to use. Okay, let's move on a little further to 1950s. 1950s, so there is this, these kinds of construction that I wanted to talk to you about. Felix Candela, a Spanish person. He, I think he was also an engineer and has a PhD in mathematics, I think. And you can actually Google about him, just write down Felix Candela, maybe I'll just write his name in the chat box here. What he did is that he used concrete to make these huge sorts of parabolic, hyperbolic, parabolic curved shapes, yeah. Imagine he is doing this in the 1950s, yeah? तो उसमें तो वहाँ पे तो कोई भी ऐसा curved what to say boards या ऐसा कुछ is not available. Because he had a PhD in mathematics, he simply figured out that these lines, when you make the scaffolding and the formwork for this thing, what you will see is that they are all actually straight lines. So if you want to, if you're excited about this guy and want to study more, you should learn about hyperbolic paraboloids. And you will see that if you want to make a foam work for this one, usme khali thin pieces of straight timber, if you use, you can make the entire structure out of it. Theek hai. So that is about Felix Candela. He actually didn't wanted to pursue this construction and architecture. I think he wanted to run a restaurant, but then I think he got called in to serve in the military, and when he came back, then he started his company or something like that. The right above this, can you see the pointer that I'm showing?
We can.
Okay, fine. So what you see here is this, the hyperbolic paraboloid, inverted slab. This is just supported on one single column. Can you see there are about like 50 people standing on that? Okay. So, and this is a very thin slab. These slabs are as thin as 70 to 75 mm. Now you can imagine how much is 7.5 centimeters, right? The slab that we use now is 125 to 150 mm. Right, so this is a restaurant, and iska slab bhi something like just 75 mm. This restaurant is in Mexico, and I think about a few years ago, in 2014 or 16, kabhi to earthquake aaya tha Mexico mein. Baki sare aju baju ke structures hill kar, they were cracks and gir gaye the, but this is still as intact with no cracks. So that's that. Let's move on to this person. His name is let me write. Nervi Pierre. I don't know if it's Pierre Luigi Nervi. Yeah. So he was also like a one-man show, the architect. He was an engineer, a structural engineer, architect also, the contractor also, and the engineer on the job. He had his own company. So what he did, so this particular structure that you see is an aircraft hangar, and these are really huge spans that you are seeing here. The spans are in hundreds, yeah. And what you see here is one of the very first instances of using ribbed slabs. Ribbed slabs or waffle slabs. I don't know if you know waffle slabs, but waffle slab something, it just looks like this. So what he figured is that because he was also the engineer and also the contractor, and how we sort of like condescendingly say that contractor ko hamesha material bachana hota hai. So it's some starts with that sort of like an intention, I guess. He started to figure that if he only used a thicker material along the edges where the stress lines are, then he can save a lot of material. So what he figured is that he charted a complete stress lines, the compressive and the tensile stress lines on the structure, and he thought ki jahan pe ye crack aayega main wahin pe material dunga, to problem solve ho gaya, right? Jahan pe fatne wala hai wahin pe main stick karunga, sort of like a as simple to put it. So that is how he sort of invented these kinds of ribbed slabs. This particular structure is demolished and is not there anymore, but many of his, you should also check out his Astrodome, I hope you guys are writing all these things down. Astrodome in Houston, and you can see the wonderful spiral ceiling that is there. This is also an instance where he has used the column. Bahut sare column lagane ke jagah par, usne ek bada fat column lagaya, baki is just sort of like connected all of them together. That's that. Should we stop here or should we continue? Because it's 12:40 now. Or should we continue? Neeraj?
hello.
I was wondering, I got disconnected or something.
I was wondering, would it be possible to stop for today? Because it got very information heavy. I think going ahead would get a little heavy.
Okay, I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that. I'm thinking the same, actually.
Thank you.
Okay, so you got all the stuff that was there. Fine. I think we can take a stop here, and maybe I think most of the stuff has been already covered. Neeraj got disconnected, kya? Pata nahi. But I think he must have covered about concrete, essential parts of concrete, and blah blah blah. So we can stop here. Yeah. All right.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Bye bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Yeah. Someone stop the recording and share that.
How do I do that?
I guess Neeraj knows it because he started the recording.
Yeah, Neeraj started the recording. So he would stop it.
Yeah, Neeraj. I was wondering if you
sir was gone, so I was
Achha. Okay, so I think we'll take a stop here. वैसे भी ये घंटे से ज़्यादा हो गया. तो that's all right. So you can share the recording.
Hello, is it recording or is it been stopped? I'm not able to see because.
It's still recording because it's showing on the side.
It stopped.
Huh?
It stopped, I guess, yeah.
Stopped now.
When I was...
Maybe when you got disconnected.
When I got disconnected, it got stopped, yeah.
Achha. Okay.
For us, it's still showing recording, that's why.
Yes.
Okay, I think next time ka class ka timings are a little different. I think, hai na, Neeraj, you want to book them?
We'll confirm it. I'll obviously share the schedule, I guess. So people all will get to know the timings and everything.
Okay, all righty. Okay.
Okay.
Now we can log out, na?
You can stop.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.